Welcome to beautiful downtown Pomona.
The first time that Pomona came into my life was in 2008. And I was invited to come to Pomona to have a show at this large community gallery called the Daw Gallery in Pomona. When I went out there and saw the space, which was a fantastic space, but it was honestly, frankly, it was a little too big at the moment for me. But I have a lot of my father's paintings. I've been taking care of both my parents for 11 years, since 2003. And I put together a father-son show. I went back to Pomona in September of 2014 to see how the mural that I had done in the previous June had been doing. And I was standing outside on the street, outside in front of this building, and realizing that they were ready to move now on actually muralizing this whole building and then what's going to become reality.
Well, Andre had a talent for kind of walking in at the right time. He walked by the school, and I happened to be standing outside. And he just walked up and he says, "And I'm going to paint the entire outside of this building." I went, "Okay, who are you?" And that started it.
It's crazy in the best way possible, yeah. You know? I mean, I work in all black and white, so to be absorbing this much color is intense and awesome. The fact it's top to bottom, left to right, full bleed, everything, the colors match, like the outline to the architecture is amazing.
And my father has just passed away within the 24 hours, and I immediately put that together to do the mural, thematically, have him inspire it. As a non-objective artist, which only deals with form and color and movement.
It's a huge statement. It's a landmark for the city of Pomona. What it means to the city, it's historic. This has never been done before at this scale. 10,000, 11,000 square feet of painted walls.
When I was starting on the first draft of the drawings, some of the imagery in the drawings, it's not completely non-objective. There are some symbolic images in there. And one of them, which is consistent throughout all the drawings, are arrows that are all going and directing upwards. I think the arrow is a symbol of positive energy, positive life. I also had some shapes in there that reminded me of cornucopias. And I thought, and knowing that the history of Pomona is really founded in agriculture, and I thought that I could say a Pomonacopia of color.
Why not teach creativity by having students enveloped in a cocoon of beautiful art? And what better way than through art like Andre's, which brings a smile to your face when you enter the campus? Many of these students have lives which are difficult. And to come to school every day, see a piece of artwork like that, it helps them to enter the day with a smile, feel good about themselves.
I have, you see there's a lot of traffic, a lot of what they call the traffic dividers, which represent the highways, the freeways, all the roads leading and coming through Pomona. I have that throughout the piece. The arrow here represents the freeways, the roads coming to Pomona. At the end, it's actually calming. I think that there's a certain zen in a lot of action.
And it's like Andre, man. You know, he's such a positive guy. To me, I think when we make art like this, like we manifest our vision and our reality of things, you know? And Miripolsky really, like, this is him, man. This is where he's at, like this big, this grand, this powerful.
He's a perfect artist to have painted that building. By all means, he's probably the only person that could have seen the vision for that building. And for him to actually pull it off and make it what it is today is amazing. Pomonacopia is going to live forever.